It's Thanksgiving weekend 2020, and I'm at the famous Yosemite National Park in California. The Yosemite Valley is a 7-mile wide canyon with incredible rock formations, including El Capitan, the world's tallest granite monolith and one of the world's top rock climbing destinations. Home to giant sequoia trees, the Yosemite National Park was established in 1890 and draws 4 million annual visitors.
We all know that people come here to Yosemite to spend time with their families or to go on hikes with their friends and just gather a lot of good moments. But let's find out, what do people actually leave behind here?
Even at such a beautiful place, there's so much of plastic trash around. There's plastic bottles here, there's soda cans, there's a mask there, and just so much plastic trash. Driving around the park, we reached Lower Yosemite Falls Trail. There was no water at the falls, but we hiked around the 1.2-mile loop trail. Here as well, the trash tail was no different. Our next stop, Bridal Veil Falls. It's difficult to spot from afar, but after a bit of climbing through rocks, we spotted several cascading falls at the bottom. The sight was simply lovely, except for the eye-soaring litter, which will eventually get washed away by the water and make it to the ocean. Yosemite is also home to a myriad of plants and wildlife. While we couldn't spot a bear, a coyote, or a sheep, we did happen to see many mule deer. And what if the plastic trash that we throw ends up being eaten by these innocent animals? It's day two, and we are at the Hetch Hetchy Valley, a peaceful stop point within the Yosemite National Park. The Hetch Hetchy Reservoir stretches 8 miles upstream of the O'Shaughnessy Dam. It produces some of the cleanest municipal water in the United States and supplies water for the city of San Francisco. As of 2013, the water storage and hydroelectric power supplied by the Hetch Hetchy project serviced an estimated 2.6 million people in the San Francisco Bay Area. Because it supplies water to the city of San Francisco, there is no recreational boating or swimming allowed here. But despite that, it's quite disheartening to see plastic trash and soda cans at a trail that runs along the sides of the reservoir. A survey conducted in 2016 showed that 59% of Americans were unaware of the monumental trash problem facing the country's national parks. Each year, more than 100 million pounds of trash is generated by visitors at Denali National Park, Yosemite, and Grand Teton. And this trash includes everything from coffee cups, plastic packaging, diapers, sanitary napkins, and these days it even includes masks. Masks are polluting not just our national parks, but also our oceans.